Welcome to this brief guide on how to share gems in Gemini. In one of my previous videos, I showed you how to create your own custom versions of Gemini called gems. They are an incredible way to tailor Gemini to your specific needs, whether you have a workspace account or a free personal account. If you want a full deep dive on how to build them from scratch, I've linked that video down in the description for you. But today, we're talking about a brand new feature that has just started rolling out, and it's a game changer for those who use Google's productivity tools. It's the ability to share your gems with other people. In this video, I'm going to walk you through exactly how to share your creations, what the different permissions mean, and most importantly, what the experience looks like for the person you're sharing with. To show you how it works, I'll be using a custom gem I've built called the Book Review Drafter. I can give it all my messy thoughts and notes on a book I've just read, and it helps me structure and draft a polished review. So, let's share it. Alright, let's dive into the practical steps. So you're looking at your main Gemini interface. You've spent the time creating the perfect gem, and now you want to get it into someone else's hands. For this demonstration, I'm using my Book Review Drafter gem, which has been a huge time saver for me. First, you'll want to bring up the list of your custom gems. I'll move my cursor over to the left-hand sidebar here, and you can see some of the gems that I've created. I'll click on Explore Gems to open my full collection of gems. Now on the right-hand side next to the gem's name, you'll see that brand new share icon. This is our starting point. So let's give that a click. This brings up the sharing dialog box. Now, if you've ever shared a Google Doc, a sheet, or Google Slides presentation, this environment will feel right at home, which is great because it makes the process intuitive. You have two primary ways to share your gem. The first, and most common for sharing with specific people, is by adding them directly via their email address. You can see the field here labeled Add People and Groups. I'm going to type in the email address of a friend that I want to share this with. This method is secure and ensures that only the people you specify will get an invitation. The second method is by creating a general access link. This is more for when you want to share your gem widely, perhaps on a website or with a large group where you don't have everyone's email. You could set it so that anyone with the link can view. For today though, we'll stick with the direct email share, as I only want my friend to have access. Now, before you go and excitedly click that send button, we need to talk about one of the most important steps here, permissions. This determines what the other person can actually do with your gem. So over here on the right, you can see that we have a drop-down menu. By default, it's set to Viewer. Let's break down what that means. A viewer here has the ability to use your gem to its full potential. So they can have conversations with it, give it prompts, and get some outputs. For my book review drafter, it means that my friend can input their book notes and get a review draft. However, they cannot see or change the secret source, those detailed instructions that I wrote to make the gem work. This is the perfect setting for sharing a finished tool. Now let's click on this dropdown. The other powerful option here is Editor. If I select Editor, I'm essentially inviting them to be a co-creator. An editor can do everything that a viewer can, plus they can see and modify the core instructions of the gem. This option is fantastic for collaboration. For example, if my friend is a brilliant editor, I might want to make them an editor here so that they can help me refine the instructions to produce even better, more nuanced reviews. You're essentially giving them the keys to the engine room. And it's worth noting for those of you who are using a Google Workspace account at your company or organization, you'll likely see even more powerful sharing options here. Just like with Google Drive, your administrator might have enabled options to share the gem with your entire organization with a single click, or with specific user groups like marketing department or sales team. This takes the collaborative power to a whole new level for professional environments, allowing you to create and distribute bespoke tools for your entire team. Now, for today's purpose though, I just want my friend to be able to use the tool as is, so I'll make sure that this is set back to viewer. I can even add in a little note here to give them some additional context. I'll just type, "Hey, give this a try for your next book review." It's a nice touch. Okay, everything looks good, so let's click send. Now the invitation has been sent, but before we go and see what it looks like for the recipient, it is worth noting that you can also use the share menu again from here if you ever need to change these permissions. You even have the ability to fully transfer ownership of your gem to someone else should you wish. Okay, so what does it look like for the person on the receiving end? This is really important. I've switched over to my friend's account now so we can see their exact experience from start to finish. Okay, so here we are inside their email inbox. As you can see, a new email has arrived from me via Google with the subject line saying, "Item shared with you, book review drafter." It's clear and official. So let's go ahead and open it. Inside though, it's very simple. It says who shared the gem, and it includes the little note that I wrote. The main call to action here is going to be this big blue open button. When my friend clicks this button, watch what happens. A new tab opens, and it takes them straight to their own Gemini account, directly loading the Book Review Drafter gem. There are no downloads, no installations, and no complicated setup steps. It just works. Now, this low barrier to entry is a massive plus when it comes to sharing and collaboration. But let's say they missed the email. If they're already in Gemini, the gem won't be immediately visible. This may change in future though, so always keep an eye out for updates. But in Google Drive, over in their left-hand sidebar, they'll have a section called Shared with Me. And right there, as you can see at the top of the list, is the Book Review Drafter. This acts as a central library for every item that has been shared with them, including gems. So, let's now test it out. I'm going to paste in some of my raw, jumbled notes about a book I just finished called The Cult of the Dead Cow. I'll just drop them into the chat box here at the bottom and press enter. Immediately, the gem gets to work. It's taking those notes, and based on the hidden instructions that I wrote, it is now structuring them into a polished draft. For the recipient, this is honestly just like magic. They're getting the full power of my custom tool without needing to know any of the background details that made it happen. It's incredibly powerful and very user-friendly. And that's how easy it is to collaborate and share your personalized AI tools using Gems. This new sharing feature opens up so many possibilities, from sharing helpful tools with your family, like a meal planner that knows your partner prefers a specific salad dressing, to distributing powerful custom assistance to your entire team at work. The real power here is in creating something once and allowing multiple people to be able to benefit from it. So, what gems are you going to build and share? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget, if you need a refresher on how to build a gem in the first place, the link to my full tutorial is in the description. Happy sharing, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.